My boy Sleek. Woo! It's a remix. Welcome, rapper, Russ Sleek.
Kingston, Jamaica.
Looks record. Me now watch the noise of the market. I'm checking for my current change. A lot of people don't know what it takes to reach this spot. I'm sure they don't really care.
When I'm in my zone, usin lete my zone, girl, leave me alone. Kablo ya kula makonde, si shindi kuwa alone. Mana so kinyonge, paka na Ross Lick. Leo tupo in our zone, baby.
So when I'm in my zone, my zone, leave me the hell alone. Alone, don't call me on the phone. The phone when I'm in my zone.
Yeah, man, 93.9 WKYS. You know what it is, DJ Flavor Show. Always holding it down. And you know I gotta do it anytime anybody come home, come here from the motherland. You know I gotta give them straight love is what I do. You know, big ups to everybody from the Gambia, anybody from West Africa. But, you know, I got East Africa in the building today, man. Tanzania, my dude Young D is here with us.
Whoa!
Yo, man,
so, I'm so excited. I feel good to be here, man.
Well, all right.
It's so good to be here.
Well, why do you feel so good? I think I have an idea of what happened last night.
You know, I mean, you know, this Radio 1 thing, we have a Radio 1, like, back home, a Radio 1, mm-hmm. a local station, like, it's been there running for so long. So, me being on another Radio 1, back, I mean, here in the U.S.,
right.
That makes me feel like I'm still at home.
Still at home.
So, big shout out to my Radio 1, to all the team that work at the Radio 1, come media house back home, man.
Well, you know, it was founded by an African-American woman. Yeah, Miss Kathy Hughes.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
I didn't know about
that. She's the founder and owner of Radio 1, and her son created TV 1.
Wow.
Yeah. It's all African-American. Oh, man.
Wow.
You hit me.
So, see, I feel at home, man.
Yeah. Welcome. So, look.
Such a good feeling.
Let's jump right into it. You got some bangers.
For real.
You got some bangers. This joint right here, I don't want to pronounce it wrong. I want to say Bongo Bahati.
Mbaya.
Mbaya.
Bongo Bahati Mbaya. BBM. You can just say BBM.
BBM.
Yeah.
This track right here, this was the one that set you off and put fire under you and catapulted you to the next level.
Yeah,
now,
yeah, that's all.
There's some political stuff around it, though, because
yeah.
It actually talks about, I think the track is talking about people being born in Tanzania being a bad thing.
Yes, something like that, but I didn't put it that way, I mean, indirectly, because I tried to make people back home feel like they can still be in Tanzania and still making their life be like just like they are living in the U.S. or somewhere. So I didn't want it to make it look like it's bad to be living in Tanzania, but yeah, you can be still living in Tanzania and you can have your own America in Tanzania.
Well, you know, a lot of people look at where they are, and I see it right here in Washington D.C., where people that are born here and or live here, but they don't take advantage of all the opportunities that are around them. I mean, the Mecca of the world migrates and comes to Washington, D.C. To do everything. All kinds of money flows through, right?
Mm.
But you followed that joint up with another song, Noma Kweli.
Noma Kweli, yeah. You already said it right.
I'm close. Mm-hmm. I'm getting close, yeah?
Yeah.
So, and that song was a follow-up up to explain more in detail what you were saying about the first one. And both of them are bangers right now.
Yeah, but the other one that you said it last, like the Noma Kweli.
Uh-huh.
That's Noma Kweli is talking about totally everything different. It's talking about mostly I've been having fun, like you and your friend, and there's a dance like we did on the
video. I saw the video.
So it's like a club banger song. They're both like club banger song, but this one, it's more like specific to the club audience. Yes.
Specifically for having fun the whole night.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and I understand that you are like the ambassador for all the youngins
I'm that guy.
So everybody, all of the youngins look up to you. They're like, I want to be like Young D.
Yeah, when they hear,
yeah.
The boys in the building.
I got it right?
Almost there.
Let me try one.
Almost
I feel like I'm laughing. What does that mean?
Just like a sign, like, you know, it's like, then you know I'm in the house. Like, wait, once you hear that, then you know I'm coming.
So they're like, here we say, oh,
uh-huh.
Yeah, so, yeah, or skirt, skirt.
Yeah.
Okay.
So when you hear that, That's Yang D right there.
Wow, and they go crazy when they hear that.
Yeah, just I mean, I've been paid from some a couple of times to just do just that on the features, like on a dude song. Like just want me to just do that.
Just to do just that.
Yeah, on an intro, so that you know.
That's crazy. Like, yeah. You get paid just to make that one sound.
Yeah, man, I'm blessed.
That's and so is that tag like copywritten?
Yeah, it is, because since I started my own company, I had to copyright all these things, you know, so that I'd be, you know, I'm secure, so that I'd be secure, but whatever that I possess, I have to be sure that this is really mine.
So, now, last night, when we started this interview, you said you felt a certain way, and I think I know why, because you hosted Stadium here last night.
Mm-hmm.
Now, is there any way, what did you feel about that spot?
Crazy, man. I mean, I couldn't even post all of the video clips that I had to take, you know, because I was scared, man. Those clips looks like porn video kind of thing.
DC got great women, man.
Yeah, for real. And I spent like all of my
spent all your money in them.
So good.
You ain't got no money to send back home.
No. I was secure. That's secure. I mean, for that night, for that specific night.
All the money, like, that you had to blow for the night, you blew it. You had to blow it.
Yeah,
that's what Stadium would do to you, man. That's a trap. That's the real trap.
But I had so much fun. Guess what? That's the first time that I've been to a strip club, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Why so? What is it that...
You can't have stuff like that back home.
Right,
you know.
Right. I mean, but they don't know. You know, like, explain. I mean, the people that's watching this, they don't know what's happening.
They know what the country strip club is, but then
but they don't know that in Tanzania that is not that you don't have that stuff there.
Yeah.
So I mean, but why? Explain why. I know why, but my listeners don't know why.
But you know, back home, there's things are moving kind of slow. You know, when it comes to stuff like this, you know, you can't, even if you do a music video back home, you cannot let girls just appear the way those girls were appealing last night. You mean, because they were obviously gonna ban the video. You're never gonna be able to even, you know, they might even ban you from doing your music back home.
Whoa.
Yeah, you know. It's just
so the freedom of speech, the freedom of everything isn't completely there.
It's taking some time. No, it's there, but it's taking some time, you know, especially in the music business. So.
Okay.
So there's this cultural thing and traditional things that they're trying to protect so that, you know, for the new generation, for the, you know, stuff like that.
Right,
trying to keep the traditional.
So how are you working with the young people? Because I do a lot of community stuff here, and I make it a point, and just like you said, there's certain things that you couldn't post last night. Mm. There's certain things that I won't post. Mm. Like, you won't find me with the alcoholic beverage in my hand, holding a bottle or anything like that. I don't really post those things because of the influence that I have on the younger generation. For me, I'm like the ambassador here in DC, Maryland, and VA when it relates to young people. So is that the reason why you didn't want to post that?
Well, for some reason, yeah, because that was too, like, that was too explicit.
They'll pull you down. They'll be like, no, you can't come back home now.
I could just feel it. Like, I mean, even myself, you know, I have a daughter back home.
Okay. Man. Oh,
so, I mean,
okay.
There was some stuff that, man, it was too much. It was good because, you know, for my eyes, because I was there, I saw it, and that was good. That was enough, so...
So you experienced Miami. Let's bounce from there.
Yeah,
you went down to Miami.
Yeah.
You came into Texas.
Wow. Miami has the beautiest, man, the prettiest girls I ever seen, man. Miami,
So how do you get into, since you've been here in the U.S., you said, I think you told me you've been here like 3 months now.
Yeah.
So when you got off the plane and you arrived in Texas, what was your thought, you know, that, you know, from you going from your country, from what you've seen, to coming here, what is your thought? What do you see? Are you inspired?
I mean, I was tired. It was a long flight.
How many hours?
Talking about 22 or something, 22 flights, oh man.
Yeah.
Can you imagine?
So,
I mean, I was tired, but... Once I landed, man, it was different. I felt like I felt so fresh. I mean, like, yeah, I'm good to go now.
You're good to go.
Yeah.
So you and you're on a millennial tour.
Yeah.
So what's the crowd reaction? Do you feel anything different as far as the crowds when you're at home versus being here in the U.S.?
The crowd is like, you can feel the cloud, like the cloud looks like so energetic. Like, you can see the vibe. always like that. You cannot miss the vibe from the crowd whenever you go to the shows in here, you know. I just, you know, they can just go back to back with you. Like, you know, one song, from the first song to the last one, they're always going to be like the same vibe. That's one thing I came to realize. So it's just you as an artist to catch up with the crowd, to make them stick to that vibe from the jump. That's one thing I came to. I'm happy to be on this movement of trying to get to that part. I mean, to that point that I'll be the one holding the crowd down, like you know,
right?
All night and shit like that. I mean, stuff like that.
Don't worry about it. We're gonna edit it up. Hey. All right, man. Anything as far as followers, people following you. Where can they follow you at? And what's your website and the whole nine?
You can follow me through my Instagram, Young Dar es Salaam, Young DarESalama. I mean, Young Dar es Salaam.
One more time. Say it one more time.
Young as young, mm-hmm. And Dar es Salaam as DarESalama.
Awesome. And that's it. Once they get there, of course, Instagram, you can get to everything else that's going on.
Young D, and you take it from there. You can see everything that I'm doing here and back home, and and for the beautiful ladies, don't hesitate to slide through the DM. There's a lot.
It goes down in the DM. It goes down in the DM. So you got any new projects coming out?
Yeah. We've been working. I'm having I'm actually making an album, and next week we start shooting some videos. So yeah, that's a lot coming.
Are you shooting videos here?
Yeah.
In the US?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right. You already got like everything all lined up.
Where's
some of the locations gonna be?
I'm gonna keep you posted. Like, that's your number. I'll holler at you.
You're gonna keep me posted.
Yeah.
Is any of it gonna be in DC? And then gonna be, where's it gonna be? Like what states?
Most likely in Miami and DC.
Miami and DC.
Yeah.
You know, we do got boats here too, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. We got water here in DC. You know, it's water. We got some beaches around.
That looks like a plan.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't got to go to Miami for everything, man. You know, you can do some stuff right here.
You know, Miami's like, I don't know much about here, but, you know, it was good when we were in Miami.
Well, you got the link. I'm the plug. You got, if you connected to Cat Daddy and me, we're the plug. We make sure you get
blood.
Whatever you
do. Blood,
Yeah. All right, man. Young D in the building.
Yep.
You know what it is. Hey, make do that for me. Yeah, man. It's 93.9 WKYS. Yeah.